Hello friends, welcome to this video on TISSNET preparation 2020. There has got a big change in the exam pattern, whether it's about the introduction of the sectional cutoff in the general awareness section or to conduct the TISSNET exam for the two courses. Many new changes have been done to the selection process. So definitely it would require a new set of strategy from your side to prepare for this exam. In this video, I will have the discussion around this new exam pattern and will try to give you a roadmap to prepare for this new exam pattern. So let's get started with this video. So this is a bird eye view of what all changes they have done to this exam. Stage 1 will constitute of the TISSNET exam, which will be common for all the programs that a student is applying for, but this time the score for TISSNET will only be used to shortlist for the next stage and it will not be counted in the preparation of the final merit list. So this is a major change that has been introduced. Other than this, there will be a TISSNET exam for the courses HRM and ODCL. This TISSNET will be of 45 marks and will have a duration of 30 minutes. This will be conducted right after the TISSNET exam. Stage 2 will be will constitute of the pre-interview test and the personal interview. Pre-interview test can be a group discussion or the written test depending on the course that you are applying for, and this time there has got a drastic increase in the percentage of this pre-interview test in the calculation of final merit list. For the courses other than HRM and ODCL, the scores for PIT and PI will be in aggregated in the ratio 70 to 30 for final selection. So this is a huge change that has been done here. 70% weightage will be given to PIT. I will try to prepare a separate video for the preparation of PIT because its weightage has drastically increased and definitely would require a new set of strategies to prepare for this PIT. For the HRM and the ODCL, the score for TISSNET, PIT and PI will be aggregated in the ratio of 30, 40 and 30. So this is basic information about the TISSNET exam. It will be of 100 marks and having a duration of 1 hour 40 minutes. This will be conducted in different centers across the country and there will be no negative marking applicable for TISSNET, but for the TISSMAT there will be a negative marking. This table is very, very important. Your whole preparation should revolve around this table. All the topics that are mentioned in this particular table, you must focus your preparation around those topics only. I will take up the mathematics and LR section and the general awareness section in this video, and I will discuss that how do you approach these two sections. There will be 30 questions from the English proficiency, 30 from the LR and 40 from the general awareness section. So under the mathematics and LR section, there are topics, many topics mentioned here. This screenshot I have taken from the website. You also shall download this table and start your preparation according to the topics that are mentioned here. Here you should note that for preparation level, they have mentioned for the mathematics and LR up to the class 10th level. So you should not waste your time preparing for the higher difficulty level of questions. You should prepare basic of all these things. They have specifically mentioned here basic of arithmetics, basic of geometry, basic of trigonometry, basic of statistics. So you should not go beyond the basics of all these topics. Talking about the number series, data interpretation and logical reasoning, I will try to make some videos on these three particular topics from the LR section. Talking about the number series, there are just 5-6 patterns that are followed in number series, and if you have idea about these patterns, definitely you can solve any question from the exam. data interpretation, there are different charts, pie chart, bar graph. So there are different approaches to solve all these different graphs. And if you have a rough idea of solving these different graphs, you can definitely easily solve any question that is asked in the exam. So I'll try to make videos on these three topics, particularly from the logical reasoning section. Now coming to the general awareness section, general awareness has been playing a crucial role in the previous year exams also, and for this year particularly there has been a sectional cutoff introduced for the general awareness section, which is of 14 marks. So definitely you cannot miss out on preparing for this general awareness section. I will come up with videos on this general awareness section, and I will discuss the different topics that are mentioned in this particular table. Now the questions in general awareness can be from the static portion or from the current affairs section. There is a wide range of topics that can be asked from this section, and students generally struggle to prepare for this section, particularly because the information is huge and they really don't know what all they have to prepare from this particular section. I will help you with the best of my efforts to prepare for this section. So it is the end of this introductory video on this TISSNET preparation 2020. Some more videos are lined up on the way. Till then, sit back, relax and keep learning.